Alright, here we have a low-rez infrared shot of my one of my hives. And if you go down here, you can see that's the hot spot. Now, I'm not sure how accurate this is. This is just a test. I'm testing it for the first time today. And anyway, this hive hasn't been in the sun, so I don't think there's much radiant heat coming off it. But right here, you can see that's the hot spot, right? The bright spot down there, that's where probably the brood nest is. And it's coming in at, you know, a little over 20 degrees. You can see, too, the handles, this here spot in the handle is slightly hotter than, say, over here in the corner. Possibly because the wood is thinner there and the heat is radiating out through that thinner part of the wood in the handle. If we come over here, and this is all, I'm just making this up now, I don't know if this, any of this is true, but anyway. You can see down there, here's the entrance, the top entrance. And if I get it right on the top entrance, so let's just say it's, say 18 degrees right there. But if I get it right on the top entrance, you can see it hits about almost 24 degrees, right? So this heat coming out of there, you can also see the bees flying around, the heat from the bees flying around, that's cool. But if right here there's a crack and there's more, a little bit of heat coming up between the honey super, which is this box right here, and the deep down below. Anyway, there's a crack right there. If you can see, if I get the crosshairs off, you can see it's a hot spot right around there. And that's because I've got a queen excluder on there, a metal queen excluder, and the metal one seems to create more of a crack and more space between the supers than, say, a plastic one, and quite a bit of heat comes out of there, which is not a big deal because it's just a little bit of ventilation. But here, look, you can see a bit, that little thing right there, that's a bee. Anyhow, so this is my Flir One for an Android phone, and it's not what I'd call a device for beekeepers on a budget, and I got it as a birthday gift. It's not something I'd normally purchase. But you can see this is about 19 degrees right there for this top of the boxes there. That top deep is empty, and then down here it gets about a little bit warmer. About 20 degrees down there. So I don't know if that means the brood is down there or the brood nest is down there, but I don't know. We can say that for now and hope for the best. Anyhow, they need to calibrate this thing. I don't know how accurate it is in terms of the temperature readings, but it still gives me a fairly good idea of what the heat that's radiating from the hives. This will be much more helpful in the winter when it's cold. And I do this at night when the sun hasn't been shining on the hives. Now, it's been a cold day today and a cloudy day, so most of this heat isn't radiated heat from the sun. It should be from the bees, but I don't know. Anyway, that's it. Kind of neat.